So we have just 1 hour to deal with
recording in progress
one important section of GS2 Indian polity. So that section that section happens to be Indian constitution and constitutional process. Okay, if we just for sake of convenience get back to last year's mains paper, I guess there were around 6 to 7 questions on this topic, or let us say segment of GS2. The very first one, obviously we have taken it as the very first question for discussion. You can read it out. Constitutionally guaranteed judicial independence is a prerequisite of democracy. Then there is another one, but slightly in a different form. Now this was the question, rather this is a question which is part of this volume second. I think those who have political science as an optional, they must have seen this. Okay, so this was published in the year 2020. UPSC last year had asked this question. What is this question? Compare and contrast the British and Indian approaches to parliamentary sovereignty. And we have included this in a very simpler version, simpler form. What is that? The parliamentary system which is introduced in our constitution subjects parliament to various limitations, explicate these limitations along with rational behind them. आपको शायद ये लगेगा कि ये तो बहुत ही अलग है, ये तो बहुत ही अलग है, जिसमें ब्रिटेन का नाम भी नहीं है. ऐसे लग रहा है आपको? नहीं लग रहा है? I would argue rather both questions are one and the same. Okay, without a specific reference to the British parliamentary system, this question very much nonetheless deals with the British parliamentary system. How we'll look into that, don't worry about that. So this, I just wanted to get back to this because this was the second one from the last year. Then there was another question which was on Constitution of India. Constitution of India is what kind of constitution or document? A living document with immense possibility of dynamism. Okay, it is made for progressive society. That was another statement. And then you were supposed to establish that in spatial reference with the way in which Article 21, that is right to life and liberty, was interpreted or rather been interpreted. So that is the third one. Okay, so let us again and again revisit to the topic we have selected for sake of convenience, constitution and constitutional process. It is not just Constitution of India, but it is along with constitution, the very process of constitution, that is implementation and execution of Constitution of India. So that is the third one. There was one more question, I think, was it on parliamentary system? So that was typically a very static kind of question. You can check it out. But then there was one more very interesting question. I'm just focusing on very few questions. Okay. It was about Article 356. If you remember, you can try to recollect it. So you were supposed to highlight, let us say, explain two reasons. One was the political reason, the other was the legal reason. For what? Less use of Article 356. Okay. The political reason has as if re-entered the political arena of our democratic setup because of the results of the 18th Lok Sabha general elections. Okay. So, you can well expect at least two questions. Okay, and anyway, I have included one more, sorry, one of the two, let us say, coalition government, resurgence of regional political parties and its likely impact or influence on Indian federalism. In general, you can make it specific saying center-state relationship. Okay, so something of that sort definitely may be asked by UPSC in this year's mains examination. Okay. Was there anything else important from last year's question paper pertaining constitutional process? I think this is more than sufficient to begin with. Okay, before we actually start with the discussion of these 8 questions along with the model answers, I'll just put forward some sort of input. Since you have written preliminary exam, all of you must have written preliminary examination 2 days back. Okay, you can evolve a strategy as far as constitution and process is concerned. That is constitutional process. You must have read Lakshmikant a lot for the preliminary examination. You can revisit that, but only for the static part. Okay. If you have your short notes, you can make it a point to revisit those short notes. That would be sufficient or enough only for the static part of the Constitution of India. Nothing beyond that. Okay. Number two, you have to take note of, and this has in recent years emphasized by UPSC in at least 4 to 5 questions. You take the question on Article 356, then Constitution of India being a living document, okay, then how Article 21 interpreted by the judiciary, and then the very first question. Again, the differences as far as the British and Indian parliamentary system are concerned towards parliamentary sovereignty. So these questions are rooted in something called as the way in which we have been implementing or executing our constitutional document. So only static part is not obviously going to be sufficient. We have to add, and that has become a substantial part of your, that has to become substantial part of your strategy, your studies as far as the coming mains is concerned. Class note is already circulated. Okay. And there are very few students, I'm sure, who must have gone through the class note, because our past experience tells us, I don't know why, when they write one mains or two mains, then they suddenly realize the significance of the class note. Okay, we have included so many important dimensions pertaining constitutional process, starting well from the very first chapter. If we, just for sake of convenience, take preamble as the very first chapter, excluding the earlier one, the constitutional history. Okay, so let us add that, number two. Number three, even PP, Praveen Patil sir, will take that aspect for discussion. Political process also is included in this paper. So political reasons as well as the legal reasons for decrees use of Article 356. Ab ye political kahan se aaya hai? Constitution is one thing, constitutional process is another thing, but then there is political reason. So obviously Indian constitution does operate not in a vacuum, but in a political framework. And I think that political framework is made up of what actors, what forces, what agencies. What are those? Political parties. Okay, then pressure groups. What else? Civil society organizations. Yes. So that, yes. So you can add so many things which are relevant. So that political process part also has to be taken note of. Obviously, the next and subsequent section, or let us say aspect, can be the governance one, more than sufficient. Okay, number one. Number two, what you can do, well, by going through Lakshmikant, your own short notes, importantly the class note, plus the current notes on current and contemporary topics, which would be made available in a span of 4 to 5 days. You don't worry about that. Be uploaded in Unix portal. Current contemporary notes on polity, IR, geography to science and technology. Okay, so that each and every topic which has current and contemporary dimension would be made available. Don't worry about that. So in a span of just 4 to 5 days. So that should be another source as far as the study material is concerned. And this is what I would suggest. This is not a marketing for political science. But you should make it a point to go through at least those questions, because this section is titled as Indian Government and Politics. Okay. And there are 11 topics. Of 11 topics, 6 topics pertain to Constitution of India and constitutional process. So you can check out questions on preamble. You can check out questions on fundamental rights. You can check out questions on DPs. You can check out questions on Indian federalism, on Indian parliamentary system. I have taken the second question from this book itself. And you can check out 3-4 questions on Article 356, which have been there since 2020, the year the book was released or published. So federalism, parliamentary system. Then regional parties have become once again important in Indian political democratic setup. So there is every likelihood that a question may appear on significance of regional political parties, so on and so forth. Okay, so at least for 5 to 6 topics, see, you have already done a lot as far as every factual minute detail of Constitution of India is concerned. Agar aap jaoge wahan pe, to kitne questions milenge aapko along with model answers on all these topics, right from preamble to, let us say, the Panchayati Raj. Let us say 10 to 15 questions along with model answers. अब एक मॉडल आंसर का सॉरी एक क्वेश्चन का मॉडल आंसर कितने पेज का होगा? 1 या 2 पेजेस होगा. सो 15 × 6, 90 क्वेश्चंस, 90 कन्वर्ट इनटू पेजेस. सो कितने पेजेस हो गए? ज्यादा से ज्यादा 90 पेजेस. ओके, एंड दीज आर नॉट जस्ट नोट्स, दीज आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मॉडल आंसर्स. ओके, and this is done, that is, this book is prepared by referring to so many original sources, okay, academic sources, so on and so forth. You can check it out, the quality of the answers. You must have read this question 1000 times, I think, at least for the first time last year when the mains was over. ये तो definitely होता है कि जैसे mains खत्म होता है या pre खत्म होता है तो देखते हैं कि क्या पूछा गया है. Okay. I think the question is sheerly, I would say, conceptual. And if at all you want to make it very, very simple, it is based on general knowledge of, you can say GS2, general knowledge of Indian constitution or constitutional process or Indian polity. In what sense it is a general knowledge? That is, it is based on general knowledge of Indian polity. I would say CSAT of Indian polity. You would feel more comfortable because you have just dealt with the CSAT paper. Isn't it so? So you can say conceptual. This has to do with the fundamentals of the subject, isn't it? So constitutionally guaranteed judicial independence is a prerequisite of democracy. So one is obviously the central topic. Democracy. Okay, but what of democracy? There are certain prerequisites of democracy, and constitutionally guaranteed judicial independence happens to be one of the prerequisites. Okay, this is how we can simplify, break down the question in a very simple manner. Okay, make it simple. Democracy require certain thing to come into being and sustain. Can we say this? So what, according to you, are those preconditions, prerequisites, according to you?
Transparency, accountability.
Yes. Free and fair elections. Okay. Rights. Separation of power. Yes. Constitution, yes.
Limited government.
What else?
Federalism.
Okay, this is more than sufficient. Okay. Now one, the most important one. Unless and until the government is based on consent of the people, we cannot look at that form of government as a democratic one. So did any of you refer to that as precondition of democracy? हाँ आपने कहा कि फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन, यस, बट वो मैकेनिज्म है. फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन हैपन्स टू बी द मैकेनिज्म. दिस इज सी सैट. दिस इज अ कॉन्सेप्चुअल, फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्चुअल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट. ओके, सो फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन हैपन्स टू बी द मैकेनिज्म, हैपन्स टू बी अ मीन्स थ्रू विच वी एस्टैब्लिश द वेरी फर्स्ट प्री रिक्विजिट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. एंड वॉट इज दैट प्रिंसिपल? रूल बेस्ड ऑन कंसेंट ऑफ द पीपल. आप मुझे 100% आई एम श्योर दिस इज वेल देयर इन द 11th स्टैंडर्ड एनसीईआरटी, नॉट द न्यू वन. उसमें कुछ तो बहुत सारा किया है. ओके, यू गॉट इट. सो एनीथिंग एल्स? सो वन इज गवर्नमेंट बेस्ड ऑन कंसेंट ऑफ द पीपल. ओके, एनीथिंग एल्स? इन दैट सेंस ऑफ द टर्म प्री रिक्विजिट, जिसके बिना हम डेमोक्रेसी का सोच ही नहीं सकते. अब देखिए प्री रिक्विजिट कितना इंपॉर्टेंट शब्द बना है. अब दोनों में फर्क है ना, कि फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन एक कहा हमने और दूसरा कहा कि नहीं रूल बेस्ड ऑन कंसेंट ऑफ पीपल. देयर इज अ फंडामेंटल डिफरेंस. सो एनीथिंग एल्स? किसी ने कहा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, यस दैट इज अनदर प्री रिक्विजिट. यानी कि यस रूल ऑफ लॉ जस्ट हैपन्स टू बी वन इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ दैट. सो रूल बेस्ड ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, यू हैव टू हैव अ डॉक्यूमेंट. ओके, एज अ लॉ ऑफ लैंड, एज अ गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल दैट वुड ऑफर अस, गिव अस, ओके, द फ्रेमवर्क विद इन विच द गवर्नमेंटल अपैरेटस विल हैव टू ऑपरेट इटसेल्फ, फंक्शन इटसेल्फ. सो democracy is also can also be understood as a form of government which operates on what law of land called as constitution. Okay, so this is the another one. Anything else? Okay, rights. Without rights we can't just imagine of democracy. I think this is more than sufficient. And then I need to pick one more thing. Somebody refer to that, separation of power. Okay, and somebody else refer to that in a very precise way, limited government. Okay, so now let us look at this. So this is one thing, prerequisite of democracy. वो तो एक खत्म हुआ हमारा. दूसरा क्या था उसमें? अब ठीक है, दूसरा तो आंसर ही है. क्या है आंसर? जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस कहा है. आपको खोजने का नहीं था कि बताइए prerequisite क्या है. क्वेश्चन में ही आंसर आपको बताया गया है कि जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस. ओके, तो ठीक है, इज जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस और डज जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस हैपन टू बी प्री रिक्विजिट ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी? इफ यस, यस द आंसर इज यस. हाउ? इन व्हाट सेंस? नाउ वी नो द आंसर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अ ब्रीफ डिस्कशन. तो आप कहेंगे ए, यस, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोटेक्ट द राइट्स ऑफ द, लेट अस नॉट से फंडामेंटल राइट्स. ओके, फंडामेंटल राइट्स इन आवर कॉन्टेक्स्ट. ओके, सो राइट्स ऑफ individuals, number one. Number two, anything else?
Separation between states. So dispute between state and
okay. Okay, and thereby see to it that the government and the entire governance process takes place on the basis of rule of law. Yes, fine. Because that requires what kind of method of settling disputes? Free and fair. So yes, absolutely yes. Anything else? Yes, to see to it that legislature and executive what? Override. Yes, what? Okay, ठीक है, jurisdiction की बात करते हैं कि आपको जो दिया गया है वही follow कीजिए, उसको override मत कीजिए. Anything else? हाँ, that is very important. Protection of constitution. And ultimately we can now say in conclusion that there is a constitution which operates as the law of the land, and each branch of government, especially legislature and executive, even the judiciary is supposed to do the same thing. But that becomes critically important for legislature and executive, because they can come up with a claim that since they have support of the people, they are free to do anything. But wo nahi nahi aisa to nahi chalega bhai. So days are gone, especially of last 10 years. We have entered a new arena now, so that is not possible. Okay, so yes, judicial independence Why does judicial independence happen to be prerequisite? Now we are very, very clear. No doubt about that. Okay, वो answer में भी है, लेकिन constitutionally guaranteed ऐसा बोला है उसको. अगर उसके बारे में हमने नहीं लिखा, दो या तीन sentence तो हमें लिखने चाहिए. Why constitutionally guaranteed judicial independence? Now you must be wondering, is there any other method through which the provision of judicial independence is made? Yes, there are. It can be left to the will of the legislature. It can also be left to the will of the executive. कि भाई आप तय कीजिए. He let the parliament make a law and then provide for judicial independence. But our constitution did not do that. There are 10 provisions. You must be well aware of that because you have just gone through the prelims. Written the prelims. Must have gone through again the same source multiple times. There are 10 provisions, but those provisions were not supposed to be written here in detail. Okay, just a mere mentioning of the same was more than sufficient. Okay, so now imagine, uska ulta imagine kijiye, ki had Constitution of India not provided for judicial independence and left to the will of the legislature and executive, what would have happened till date? उल्टा सोचिए ना कि अगर ये नहीं होता तो क्या होता. तो आप कहेंगे कि सर उसका आप सोचिए मत, ना बात किया तो ही अच्छा रहेगा, इतना बुरा होता. यू गॉट इट? सो हमारे राइट्स, माइनॉरिटी के राइट्स, राइट्स ऑफ द स्टेट्स बिकॉज वी आर अ फेडरल पॉलिटी, ओके, देन रूल ऑफ लॉ, और पूरा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ही खत्म होता. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ वी सी समटाइम्स रीडिंग क्वेश्चन वेरी केयरफुली helps you a lot, always actually, but in these kinds of conceptual questions, that exercise helps you a lot. Okay, now we'll take just 2 minutes and just go through the entire answer. Okay, now, is limited accountable and responsible form of government based on consent of people? Agar is tarike ka sentence aap pehla likhoge na as an introduction to your answer, to examiner ko pata chalega ki aapko pura ka pura question pata chala hai. Okay. जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस इज वन ऑफ द प्री रिक्विजिट ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, और उसका कारण भी दिया हमने, फॉर इट्स सेफगार्ड्स द इसेंशियल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी सच एज इंडिविजुअल एंड माइनॉरिटी राइट्स, रूल ऑफ लॉ, फेयर प्रोसीजर एंड जस्टिस, एंड अल्टीमेटली द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रूल. अब मुझे बताइए, हर एक क्या कहेंगे उसको, फॉरगेट द सेंटेंस, एवरी वर्ड यू वुड फाइंड इट इन एनसीईआरटी बुक. ओके, अब इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ जुडिशियरी. डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट फंडामेंटली इज अ लिमिटेड एंड रिस्ट्रेंड फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली वी हैव टू मेक एन आर्ग्यूमेंट विच रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ जुडिशियरी, कि वो क्या है और वाई डू वी नीड वॉट इंडिपेंडेंट जुडिशियरी और जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस. सो पहला क्या वाक्य है, डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट फंडामेंटली इज अ लिमिटेड एंड रिस्ट्रेंड फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. Hence, the principle of separation of powers and checks and balances constitute an integral part of it. Independent judiciary is an inbuilt part of this constitutional architecture, which on one hand settles the dispute between parties and on the other hand ensures constitutional rule. Nothing is complex. Okay. It is only through independent judiciary that the government and legislature of the day can be made accountable. An autonomous court also can prohibit executive from using its power arbitrarily. Moreover, it can also curb the brute force sought to be used by government in the name of enjoying majority. So this part clearly, that is, seeks to clearly establish the significant, the need, the requirement and the purpose of the independence of judiciary. Okay, Indian constitution, now we should not forget that we are writing UPSC examination. UPSC happens to be part of India. Okay. So, Indian constitution therefore has included several provisions to ensure independence of judiciary. However, ab maine ek bhi usko mention nahi kiya. You can do that. Don't worry about that. However, it needs to be underlined that the provision of independent judiciary is not left to the legislative or executive will. If judicial independence is left to the other branches, these branches would establish a restrained judiciary without the power of judicial review. And even if it is granted, the power can be taken away by the other branches at any time. So hence, the principle of judicial independence is made an integral part of Indian constitutional architecture in the form of 1, 2, 3, 4, that's more than sufficient because that is not expected. Okay, अब constitutionally guaranteed. उसका purpose क्या है? ऊपर भी आया है, खाली मैंने उसको enlist किया है. Rule of law, protection of rights, accountability through judicial review, constitutional rule, public faith in democracy, ये ultimate है. Okay, और मैंने यहाँ पे एक दिया है, देखिए थोड़ा थोड़ा एक एक एग्जाम्पल भी दिया है. ओके, इलेक्ट्रल बॉन्ड, डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर, पब्लिक फेथ इन डेमोक्रेसी. स्पेशली इट बिकम्स इम्पॉर्टेंट कि जब पीआईएल एंड जुडिशियल एक्टिविज्म बिकेम द फिनोमेना, ओके, इन 70s एंड 80s, एंड दैट इज द पीरियड विच इज जनरली नोन एज द पीरियड ऑफ डिक्लाइन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. ओके, so when people had started departing from the mainstream political forces, so we had as if lost faith in political parties, so the parliament was fractured, what people were looking at new political forces such as regional political parties, so on and so forth. Okay, so decline of parliament, decline of executive, and interestingly enough, at the same time our judiciary comes forward and takes a very activist position, and that is how, and the most important instrumentality which is used by judiciary, as if it is invented by judiciary, happens to be PIL, public interest litigation, and that is how the phenomena judicial activism became part and parcel of the Indian political system. Now conclusion dekhiye, thus as the constitution makers were well aware of the anomalies of leaving judicial independence to the other branches of government. अब ये एनोमली क्या है आपको लिखना नहीं है, ऊपर लिखा है हमने. ओके, द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ जुडिशियल इंडिपेंडेंस फाउंड अ वेल एंट्रेंच्ड प्लेस इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इटसेल्फ. जिस जो क्वेश्चन है उसी पे हिट करता है कंक्लूजन. ओके, नाउ यू शुड नॉट से दैट सर सर जीएस का आंसर में ऐसे कैसे हो सकता है, जीएस में तो कुछ भी लिखेगा तो भी चलेगा, ऐसा नहीं है. सो यू कैन सेट दैट टारगेट. You can think of introducing each and every answer, even if of a short note, 10 marker short note, in as precise manner as possible. ये definitely हो सकता है ना, ये इसमें कुछ complexity तो definitely नहीं है. Okay. I hope you don't have any doubt here. Okay, so this is how we are supposed to approach such conceptual questions. And it is not that difficult. It is not certainly that difficult. हाँ, ये definitely है. सर आपको पिछले साल क्वेश्चन पता चला, उसके बाद एक साल आपको आंसर लिखने के लिए समय मिला, ऐसा तो आपको नहीं होगा. यू गॉट इट. सो ऑन द स्पॉट यू हैव टू व्हाट आर्टिकुलेट यूअर सेल्फ, कलेक्ट एंड गैदर यूअर थॉट्स एंड राइट इट डाउन. ये तो डेफिनेटली है, नो डाउट अबाउट दैट, आई एग्री. ओके, नाउ द सेकेंड वन, अब देखिए ये क्वेश्चन तो सिंपल ही है. पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम विच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सब्जेक्ट्स पार्लियामेंट टू वेरियस लिमिटेशंस. अब ये अलग अलग तरीके से पूछा जा सकता है और गया भी है एक्चुअली. ओके, बोथ इन जीएस एज वेल एज पॉलिटिकल साइंस, इवन इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. डज इंडियन पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम हैव द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री सॉवरनिटी? ओके, सो ऐसा पूछा गया है. ओके, देन समटाइम्स अ क्वेश्चन ऑन स्ट्रगल बिटवीन सॉरी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन लेजिस्लेचर एंड जुडिशियरी. ओके, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द क्लेम ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री सॉवरनिटी एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड जुडिशियल सुप्रीमसी, एंड दैट यू मस्ट हैव रेड 1000 times दैट पार्ट विच टुक द फॉर्म ऑफ द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन फंडामेंटल राइट्स इन जनरल एंड राइट टू प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी इन पर्टिकुलर on one hand, and directive principles of state policy in general, and Article 39 B and C particularly. So many cases, the very First Amendment Act, the Shankri Prasad, then the Bela Banerjee, then the Golaknath, then amendments, we should not forget the amendments, the first one, the fourth one, the 17th one, the 24th one, 25th one, 29th one, which were subsequently challenged in court of law, the Keshavanand Bharati. So the doctrine of basic structure, so on and so forth. Okay, again, 42nd Amendment Act, then the Minerva Mills case. Okay, beech mein Raj Narayan bhi hai in alag context. Okay, So there is no doubt about that. But this is a very simple question. Parliament is subjected to different constraints or limitations. But that write-up would help you a lot in answering so many questions, alag-alag type ke questions. और ये उसका भी आंसर था मेरे ख्याल से, ये जो था ना कि क्या अप्रोच में डिफरेंस है. देर इज नो डाउट दैट आवर पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम इज डीपली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय एंड देयरफॉर इंडेप्टेड टू द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम. बट ऑन द अदर हैंड देर आर फंडामेंटल डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन टू फॉर्मेट्स, द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट्री एज वेल एज द इंडियन पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम. ओके, अब उसमें उसके डिटेल में मैं नहीं जाता हूँ. फैक्टर्स दैट लिमिट द सॉवरेंटी एंड सुप्रीमेसी ऑफ इंडियन पार्लियामेंट, रिटन नेचर ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. नाउ व्हाट इज सुप्रीम इन इंडियन पॉलिटिकल कॉन्टेक्स्ट और कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल कॉन्टेक्स्ट, वो पॉलिटिकल बड़ा करते हैं उसको, इंडियन पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेटिक फ्रेमवर्क, व्हाट इज सुप्रीम. नाउ समबडी वुड से नो 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 सर, पीपल आर सुप्रीम, देर इज नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. बट इन टर्म्स ऑफ documents, in terms of agencies, actors, so and so forth, there is no doubt that Constitution of India is supreme. So, since we have written constitution, unlike the Britain, we accepted and we are known for, that is the Indian parliamentary ethos is known for supremacy of the constitution. So, the very fact that we have written constitution operates as the important limitation on parliament's power. Okay. So this has to come as the first point, first limiting point. नीचे मत लिखिए उसको, सबसे पहले आना चाहिए, because there is a rationale behind that. Okay, Article 13 particularly, Article 13 particularly, लेकिन उसका भी है. दूसरा क्या लिखा है देखिए, Federal System of Government. So we have division of power, no doubt about that, through three lists, and Indian Parliament has power to enact laws on only those subjects which are part of union list and on the other hand the concurrent list. But the state list, the subjects which are part of state list are out of the purview, you know for that. Wo 5vi 6vi kaksha se padhte aa rahe hain, there is nothing great in that. Now the system of judicial review, which is very now unlike British system hai na, ek bhi nahi hai usme, ye pura ka pura Indian parliamentary setup ka hissa hai. Judicial review, we have independent judiciary with the power of judicial review, and there are number of articles you can well make mention of those articles, article 13, 32, 226, so many articles, important articles. Okay, so the system of judicial review, aap thodi chalaki bhi kar sakte ho yahan pe ki dekhiye, independent judiciary and judicial review. Now if I ask you a question, judicial review is inbuilt part of the scheme of separation of power in our democratic setup. There is no doubt about that. However, and we have been expecting a question on this, and I have been expecting this for last 10 years. Don't know when is that going to happen. And I'm serious. The scope of judicial review is ever increasing. अभी यूपीएससी ने कभी नहीं पूछा है, लेट अस एक्सेप्ट. अब देखिए, सो कैन वी से दैट द स्कोप ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू इज एवर इंक्रीजिंग. नाउ वी कैन से लुक एट पीआईएल, व्हाट एल्स कैन वी प्रोवाइड एज एन एविडेंस, पुट फॉरवर्ड एज एन एविडेंस. बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड अगेन वी हैव बीन एक्सपेक्टिंग अ क्वेश्चन ऑन दैट. बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन में हर तरीके से क्वेश्चन पूछा गया है, लेकिन वी हैव बीन एक्सपेक्टिंग अ क्वेश्चन ऑन इन व्हाट एग्जैक्ट वे द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर हैज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड द एम्बिट ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू, द नेचर एंड एम्बिट ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू, ये भी आप सोचिए उसमें है. ओके, सो यू कैन चेक इट आउट, डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर पे है ये क्वेश्चन, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. सो लेट अस कट इट शॉर्ट, द पावर ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू has not witnessed any kind of constraint. Rather, the case is very opposite. The scope of the power of judicial review has increased, and doctrine of basic structure happens to be the, let us say, the evidence, you can say, the basis on the basis of which we can come up with that kind of argument. Okay. And then the fundamental rights. I think these are four fundamental bases which can be used to differentiate the British parliamentary ethos, okay, from that of the Indian. Sorry, we can use this in order to distinguish the Indian parliamentary ethos from that of the British parliamentary ethos. Okay. ये 2013 में गया था, ये भी फिर से वही है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया कीप्स अ चेक ऑन आर्बिट्ररी पावर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट इन अमेंडिंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अब ये भी इतना सिंपल स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड था, बट हाउ डज कोर्ट डू दैट? अब उसमें सो वन पार्ट अनडाउटेडली हैज टू बी द पावर ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू विच इज असाइंड बाय कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया. वो तो एक ही दो सेंटेंस में हो जाएगा ना, लेकिन आपको तो 10 मार्क के लिए था वो, तो यू हैव टू रेफर टू द केसेस. ओके, अमेंडमेंट्स एंड द केसेस, द लैंडमार्क केसेस टिल द रिसेंट वन. अब जो सबसे बड़ा था कौन सा था? विच वुड यू रेफर एज द लास्ट रिसेंट एग्जाम्पल? यस, दैट वॉज द वन. यानी कि जहां पे जिस वर्डिक्ट में कोर्ट ने सेट असाइड कर दिया था कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट को. कोई कहेगा कि इलेक्ट्रल बॉन्ड का, वो तो अमेंडमेंट नहीं था ना वो, सो दैट वाज अ स्कीम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. ओके, बिकॉज लेट अस रीड द क्वेश्चन. अमेंडिंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, ओके, दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, अब उसका लेट अस नॉट फॉरगेट, ये मैं भूल गया, ऐसी गलती हो सकती है आपसे, हो सकती है. देखिए क्या कीवर्ड है, हाँ, डिस्कस क्रिटिकली. अगर ये नहीं होता तो यहां हमारा आंसर खत्म होता, एंड ऑफ द स्टोरी. आपको कुछ नहीं कहना है, लुक, इंडियन पार्लियामेंट इज गिवन पावर टू अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, बट दैट पावर डज नॉट हैपन टू बी अनरिस्ट्रेन्ड पावर. इट इज नॉट आर्बिट्ररी बिकॉज द इंडियन सुप्रीम कोर्ट बीन असाइंड द पावर टू जुडिशियल, सॉरी, रिव्यू द अमेंडमेंट, इंक्लूडिंग द अमेंडमेंट. अब जो एम्बिग्यूटी थी बहुत साल चली, लेकिन दैट एम्बिग्यूटी बीन डन अवे विद इन द फेमस केशवानंद वर्डिक्ट, वी नो फॉर श्योर. और कहा कि आप अमेंड तो कर सकते हो, बट यू कैनॉट वायलेट बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन. ओके, नाउ दैट इज अ वेल एस्टेब्लिश फैक्ट. तो उसका मतलब ये है कि अमेंडिंग पावर ऑफ इंडियन पार्लियामेंट इज रिस्ट्रेन्ड वन, द कंस्ट्रेन्ड वन. ये तो हम एस्टेब्लिश कर सकते हैं केसेस, लेकिन उसको क्रिटिकली असेस करने के लिए बोला है. क्रिटिकली असेस, क्या उसमें कोई लिमिटेशन है? ओके, अब देखिए, इवन दो द जुडिशियरी हैज प्लेड एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. अब मैंने पहला ही हिस्सा सेंटेंस का ऐसा लिखा है. क्यों लिखा है ऐसा? इवन दो द जुडिशियरी हैज प्लेड एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन सेफ गार्डिंग द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बाय रिस्ट्रेनिंग पार्लियामेंट्स पावर टू अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. उसमें सब है, क्योंकि क्रिटिक का पहला हिस्सा क्या है कि उसका कुछ ना कुछ तो इंपॉर्टेंस है, तो उसी में लाया है हमने. द कोर्ट सीम्स टू हैव अज अ एक्सेसिव पावर्स, द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर डॉक्ट्रिन इट इज आर्ग्यूड. हम कह रहे हैं ऐसा उनको, लेट अस नॉट इन्फॉर्म दैट, सो कि नहीं नहीं ये मेरा ही कहना है, इसलिए कॉमा इट इज आर्ग्यूड. व्हाइल इंपोजिंग रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑन पार्लियामेंट हैज टिल्टेड द बैलेंस इन फेवर ऑफ द अनइलेक्टेड एंड अनअकाउंटेबल जुडिशियरी बाय अकॉर्डिंग टू इटसेल्फ द राइट टू डिसाइड व्हाट कॉन्स्टिट्यूट्स द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड देयर बाय द पावर टू स्ट्राइक डाउन इवन एन अमेंडमेंट मेड बाय पॉपुलरली इलेक्टेड पार्लियामेंट. ये बहुत ही सिग्निफिकेंट क्रिटिसिज्म है, ओके, ऑफ द पावर ऑफ जुडिशियल रिव्यू विच इज अक्वायर्ड बाय जुडिशियरी थ्रू द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर. तो क्या होता क्या है, इट इज थ्रू डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर एज इफ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ वीटो पावर इज अक्वायर्ड बाय जुडिशियरी, दैट इज दैट ब्रांच ऑफ गवर्नमेंट विच इज अनअकाउंटेबल एंड अनरिप्रेजेंटेटिव. ओके, सो दैट इज द क्रिटिकल, सॉरी, दैट इज द सेंट्रल पॉइंट. इट इज ऑल्सो आर्ग्यूड that this doctrine can come in the way of necessary social and economic changes. If you get back to the debate of 60s till 1973, aapko yahi sunne ko milega ki government of the day used to say that these amendments are essential or were essential to, yes, to establish that objective of socialistic pattern of society, that is redistribution of resources, property, wealth, so and so forth. तो ये दूसरा क्रिटिसिज्म है. अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट क्रिटिसिज्म इज द अनआइडेंटिफाइड एंड अनसर्टन नेचर ऑफ द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर. यस, इट इज अनसर्टन बिकॉज टुमारो समथिंग एल्स कैन बी एडेड टू द लिस्ट. सो ये भी है उसमें. The lack of principled and well-defined tenets of the basic structure makes it highly ambiguous and subjective matter, which is entirely left to the mercy of the court. अब ये criticism खत्म हुआ है. Even though the doctrine is a step in right direction, in order to make it more effective, it is necessary that the court should provide well-defined and objective guidelines for determining the basic structure. That's it. So this is just one way of concluding. You can come up with another way of, another relevant way of concluding your answer. So ये part क्यों हमें डालना पड़ा उसमें? क्योंकि the keyword was different. Critically discuss ऐसा बोला है उसमें. Okay. So no doubt parliament has to have power to amend the constitution. However, that cannot be claimed in an unrestrained manner. Therefore, we require judicial review. However, the manner in which the judicial review is used, employed, there are also certain gray areas. That is how we can sum up the answer. Okay. अब ये देखिए, उस पे तो हर दूसरे साल क्वेश्चन पूछा गया है, डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर. अब उसमें तो पॉइंट्स तो बहुत सारे हैं. Should I discuss it? There are two straight parts. Okay, now number one. The Supreme Court of India devised the doctrine as a mechanism to limit the powers of legislature to amend the constitution. It gives judiciary the power to declare. You can go through the introduction. You can even come up with another kind of introduction. Okay. Justification. Upendra Bakshi, a renowned scholar, argued that if you do not apply BRICS, the engine of amending power would soon overrun the constitution. This sentence itself can be picked by UPSC and a question can be asked on that. Okay. In this sense, the idea behind the doctrine is to ensure that a brute majority in the parliament does not override the founding ideals of the constitution. Okay. So this is one justification. Second, some judges argue that the founding fathers of the Indian constitution put tremendous efforts of careful debate and deliberation into framing the constitution. Such effort cannot be simply subject to whims of a special majority. Therefore, certain principles ought to be treated as inalienable and thereby unamendable. Okay. It is outcome of a sheer hard work and lot of imagination. So can we leave it to the whims and fancies of some sort of brute majority? Not at all. Principles, we are saying. So core principles, there are certain core principles. Okay. Now three, some constitutional experts have concluded that the power to amend does not imply, this is very important, power to overhaul. Yani ki completely change kar sakte hain usko? Uske tahit? To a difference has to be made here. To change something and to revolutionary change something, because change is a very general and broader idea. Change can be a simple reformatory change and change can also be a revolutionary change. So, does Indian Parliament, as far as this power to amend the constitution is concerned, enjoy power to revolutionary change the constitution of India? Not at all. So, one has to differentiate between the two. These are the three important arguments on the basis of which doctrine of basic structure is supported, is justified by the scholars. Okay. Now look at the other side of the debate. The doctrine been criticized for lack of coherence and clarity. Ashok Desai argued that if you want to use names of the scholars, you can. The basic structure doctrine was developed as a rare residuary power to be used by court to control the excessive majority. However, its formulation is not precise. It can tempt a judge to invoke doctrine and try to mold the constitution in his own imagination. Second, the doctrine has been applied even to ordinary laws and executive actions. Ab usme farak hai na? There is a difference between a parliamentary law and a constitutional law. So, doctrine has to be applied to constitutional law. If you start applying to even ordinary laws, then that doesn't make sense. That's the argument. Okay. Pratabhanu Mehta has called this a source of confusion as the courts have been unclear about the scope of the doctrine. Har ek sentence, I'm not saying because I have written the answers, okay, I have taken from different sources, okay. So, but we have to be as precise, as sharp, okay, as relevant as possible. Number three, the courts failed to set some clear judicial standards in basic structure review. Therefore, its application in the domain of constitutional jurisprudence has often been an issue of agreement. Sorry, issue of disagreement. Clear judicial standards. Har ek argument mein kuch na kuch to central point hai, usko aap underline kar sakte ho. Fourth, the doctrine of basic structure is believed to have disturbed the distribution of separation of powers between the three branches of government as the judiciary enjoys a potential veto over parliamentary legislation. See, our constitution makers, our constitution has expected, imagined of a very delicate balance, a kind of delicate balance between three branches. And they did not expect, the constitution makers did not expect either of the three branches to override the other two branches. So that is a delicate balance. But the critics argue that somewhere the balance is tilted towards the judiciary. Okay. Fifth, the judiciary is not a democratically elected body and therefore its power to unilaterally determine which provision in the constitution form part of the basic structure is seen as undemocratic. And therefore, one argument goes like this. The power to determine doctrine of basic structure, that is, as to what constitutes doctrine of basic structure, what is part of doctrine of basic structure, is as of now wholly and solely enjoyed by judiciary. It is as good as deciding as to what constitute constitution. What is constitution? It is as good as that. It is not just limited to interpreting constitution. It is as good as deciding what is constitution. And there is a difference between the two. Okay. So it has gone beyond the jurisdiction, the kind of the ambit, let us say, the scope of judicial review, which was expected. Raju Ramchandran calls the doctrine as essentially anti-democratic and counter-majoritarian. It also prevents the nation from putting the lessons learned from the politics and economics into the constitution. Okay. Lastly, the constitutional amendments enacted by the democratically elected representatives of the people are seen as expression of the sovereignty, and the review of these amendments can be perceived as a review of the sovereign will. And does court enjoy that power? That's the question. You got it? See, who amends constitution? Which branch? We know for sure, parliament. And this is a claim. This is part of the criticism. Let us not forget about that. Okay. So they claim that this is done by the branch of government, that is the legislature, which manifests people's will and sovereign will. So aap uske upar usko veto de rahe ho. Ye kya baat hui? That's the criticism. That's the criticism. Okay. And there are other, this book consists of 3-4 different kinds of questions on doctrine of basic structure. Okay. So you can just check it out. I hope this is more than sufficient. I hope there is no doubt. No doubt here. Okay. But do it very carefully because that is one of the favorite topics of UPSC, doctrine of basic structure. Okay. Ab ye hum expect kar rahe is saal. The era of coalition politics in India has led to the correction in practice, if not in theory, of many of the aberrations in functioning of federal system in India. अब जैसे मैंने किताब में 2021 में डाला था वैसे मैंने लिया है वो चेंज हो सकता है ओके क्या हो सकता है क्या क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकता है इस साल इंपैक्ट ऑफ कोएलिशन पॉलिटिक्स ऑन फेडरलिज्म ऐसा भी पूछा जा सकता है ना इंपैक्ट इन्फ्लुएंस ओके उसको कॉम्प्लेक्स भी किया जा सकता है ओके लाइकली इंपैक्ट भी पूछा जा सकता है अब ये आया है तो लेकिन लाइकली के बजाय मुझे लगता है कि पिछले वाला भी पूछा जा सकता है बिकॉज इट्स दिस इज नॉट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम वी हैव एंटर्ड द ईरा ऑफ कोएलिशन गवर्नमेंट वी हैड अर्लियर ओके एंड नाउ वंस अगेन वी हैव सॉर्ट ऑफ एंटर्ड वंस अगेन ओके सो दिस इज वॉट वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग पॉइंट्स ध्यान में रखिए दीज पॉइंट्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट वन federal units have exerted greater influence in the policy making process of the center as the union government of the coalition era of ye baki ka bhul gaye to bhi chalega. What is important? The federal units, kya hua, sorry, ha, the federal units have exerted greater influence in the policy making process of the center as the union government of the coalition era operated on the basis of the terms set in the common minimum program or other such pre-decided conditions at time of forming the coalition. Ab abhi ka jo government hai NDA, aisa to kuch nahi hai unka, common minimum program aisa kuch nahi, pehle tha, abhi nahi hai. We'll have to wait and watch, but they'll have to do that. There is no doubt about that. Okay, so no, I'm serious. They'll have to do that. Influence in the policy making process, that is the first one. Second, the central government, अब ये मैंने was लिखा है ना, अब उसको थोड़ा रिफ्रेम करना पड़ेगा. जैसे मैंने बताया कि 2021 वाला मैंने वैसे के वैसे लिया है. Has to be more sensitive towards, so was and has to be sensitive towards the specific concerns and sensibilities of the states, even on matters that pertain to the union list, such as foreign policy. अब उसका एग्जाम्पल है, हमें सबको पता है. ओके, वेस्ट बंगाल को आपका सोचना पड़ता है वेन एवर यू आर डीलिंग विथ बांग्लादेश. सो इज द केस ऑफ तमिलनाडु वाइल डीलिंग विथ श्रीलंका, पंजाब पाकिस्तान, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर पाकिस्तान. अब वो जम्मू एंड कश्मीर नहीं रहा है, लेकिन फिर भी आपको देखना पड़ेगा उसका. ओके, सो दिस इज द सेकेंड वन, सेंसिटिव टूवर्ड्स द स्पेसिफिक कंसर्न्स ऑफ द स्टेट्स. ओके, उसको अंडरलाइन कीजिए. नंबर टू. नंबर थ्री, रीजनल पार्टीज हैव एमर्ज्ड. अब ये सच निकला है, ये पहले लिखा था लेकिन सच है, ये पहले भी सच था अभी सच है. एमर्ज एज ए स्ट्रांग फोर्स ऑन द इंडियन पोलिटिकल स्टेज, रिड्यूसिंग द पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ अ सिंगल पार्टी अटेम्प्टिंग टू होमोजेनाइज द इंडियन फेडरेशन. इट इज फॉर दिस रीजन दैट एनक्रोचमेंट अपॉन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट्स ऑफ स्टेट्स सच एज लिंग्विस्टिक एंड कल्चरल राइट्स बाय एनी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट व्हाट रिमेन्स अ डिफिकल्ट पॉसिबिलिटी. आपको डेफिनेटली सोचना पड़ेगा उसका. ओके, सो रीजनल पार्टीज, तीसरा है रीजनल. आपको लगेगा कि ये पहला क्या था, दूसरा क्या था, तीसरा क्या था, इतना ओवरलैप है उसमें, बट नन द लेस यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल. पहला क्या था, लेट अस ट्राई टू रिकॉलेक्ट, पॉलिसी मेकिंग प्रोसेस, लेट अस नॉट फॉरगेट दैट. नंबर टू, द कंसर्न्स ऑफ द स्टेट्स, पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक कंसर्न्स ऑफ द स्टेट. नंबर थ्री, रीजनल पार्टीज. ओके, नंबर फोर, greater participation of regional and smaller parties in national coalition government has ensured that sub-nationalist tendencies find a legitimate outlet for their grievance. Ab ye kya hai, ye kya hai? Now our home minister yesterday, if I am not wrong, you can correct me, had stated that soon he is going to have a sort of talk with two states from northeastern India. He did say that yesterday. Kaun se states hai wo? One is the Manipur, other is the Nagaland. You got it? So, sab, ab usko aap kahenge ki sir, usko sub nationalist keh sakte hai ka? Nagaland ka to definitely hai. Nagaland ka to definitely hai. Okay. So, in any democratic setup, even if the issue is very, very grave, okay, and if the other party, the opposite party, has resorted to violent means, we have to, as part and parcel of the democratic edifice, keep on saying and also trying to deal with the issue in a democratic, peaceful manner and negotiations, not the military means. Whenever in a democracy military means are resorted to, then that is done as a last resort. Uska matlab ye hi hota hai कि द डेमोक्रेटिक, ऑल डेमोक्रेटिक मीन्स हैव फेल्ड. यू गॉट इट? सो वी हैव टू कीप निगोशिएटिंग विथ इवन द व्हाट द अदर पार्टीज, इवन इफ इट इज व्हाट यूजिंग वायलेंट नॉन पार्लियामेंट्री व्हाट एंटी डेमोक्रेटिक नॉन डेमोक्रेटिक मीन्स वेन एंड सो फॉर. सो ये आपको करना ही पड़ता है. सब नेशनलिस्ट टेंडेंसीज फाइंड अ लेजिटिमेट आउटलेट फॉर द ग्रीवेंसेस. ओके, कोएलिशन पॉलिटिक्स has also led to greater fiscal autonomy. Aap mudda aane wala hai, ki aane wala meeting kab hai of GST? 23rd of June, ya 26th of June? I can forget, I can take liberty in forgetting things, but you can't. Okay, that is going to be a very interesting meeting of GST in this new scenario, let us say. Okay, so greater fiscal autonomy. And one important thing is going to be a headache for our new, prime minister in new era. Sorry. the demand by both the states, Andhra as well, yes, special category states. And we have included one question on that because we are expecting a question on that. Okay. So, greater fiscal autonomy for the states, since the regional parties push for greater allocation of resources from the center pool using their political capital. Now, since in a federal setup, states are the implementing agencies for flagship schemes, the era of coalition politics has allowed for consensus building over the formulation and implementation of important social policies. Pehla tha, alag tha wo. Okay, ab ye alag context mein humne diya hai usko. Okay, yes. It is for this reason that during NDA 1, UPA 1, UPA 2 regimes, welfare schemes with sufficient flexibility to the states could be what? Yes, such as the right to education, so on and so forth. There was a common complaint from state governments that one size fits all policy was being pushed by the central government. And NEET happens to be one of the recent examples. It was the state of Tamil Nadu, which was constantly saying that this is not good. And look what has happened. Okay, so that is very important. And the eighth one, the coalition governments have also enabled development planning and execution to be more effective, since the regional parties have to worry about, yeh bahut important hai. Nitish Kumar has to think of 2025. Yes, I am serious. And Chandrababu Naidu, okay, he has risen from ashes, let us see. Yes, credit must be given to him. Nobody had anticipated that. Nobody. Okay. Not even BJP. Baki ka to jaane dijiye. Lekin, ab unko agla election ka bhi sochna padega. Aap kahenge ki sir, abhi abhi hua hai. He has become CM, chief minister of baki ka baad mein sochenge. Lekin unko sochna padega. Okay. So, be more effective since the regional parties have to worry about their constituencies development to secure their next electoral victory. Okay, so I think these are specific points. Okay, and you can well add, if you come up with some other extra, let us say, specific point to highlight the way in which, one more way in which what coalition politics, what influences federalism or influence federalism. Ab uska flip side maine nahi diya hai kyunki question maine waise frame kiya tha. Yes, वो भी पूछा जा सकता है क्रिटिकल असेसमेंट लेटर से, तो वो आप पढ़ सकते हो, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. हाँ, ये तो बहुत ही फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन है. व्हाट इज स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेटस टू स्टेट्स, हाउ फार हैज दिस स्टेटस रिमेन्ड रेलिवेंट टूडे. वो मैंने सब दिया है, स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेट्स क्या है, कब आया था, कितने स्टेट्स है, उसके क्राइटेरियाज क्या है, क्योंकि समय हुआ है, उसके बेनिफिट्स क्या है, ये पूरा टेक्निकल डिटेल है. ओके, एंड देन ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है, प्रोग्रेसिव डायल्यूशन ऑफ दिस स्टेटस राइट फ्रॉम 2015 एंड 16 बजट, उसके टेक्निकल डिटेल्स मैंने दिए हैं. दैट वाज़ द फर्स्ट बजट 2015 एंड 2016 वाला बजट था. ओके, वो देखिए उसके बाद. सो 14 फाइनेंस कमीशन रिकमेंडेशंस. ओके, दैट इज अनदर वन. एंड द थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, वो मैंने अलग से डाला है, रघुराम राजन कमिटी हैड कम अप विथ रिकमेंडेशंस. 4 रिकमेंडेशंस उसमें है, ये आप ध्यान में रख सकते हो, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. एंड सेंट्रल पोजिशन, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स पोजिशन. अब ये वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग अ क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस एज वेल, इवन इफ द ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड हैज नॉट बीन सो, नॉनदलेस अ क्वेश्चन इज लाइकली टू बी आस्क्ड ऑन इलेक्शन कमीशन. अब उसको हमने बहुत अच्छी तरीके से फ्रेम तो किया है क्वेश्चन को, एनालाइज इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया क्रूशियल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू प्रिजर्विंग डेमोक्रेसी इन इंडिया. दिस ईयर वॉज सिग्निफिकेंट नॉट ओनली फॉर डेमोक्रेसी, दैट इज इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी, बट मेनी डेमोक्रेसीज अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड, क्योंकि बहुत सारे नेशन स्टेट्स में इलेक्शन हो रहे थे, इसीलिए दिया है. मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट, मेकिंग इलेक्ट्रल प्रोसेस मोर इंक्लूसिव, रिड्यूसिंग वोटर्स एपैथी, डीलिंग विथ न्यू फॉर्म्स ऑफ एक्सीजेंसीज, डिमांड फॉर रिफॉर्म्स न्यू इनिशिएटिव्स, ओके, उसमें आपको करंट वाला एक नोट मिलने वाला है, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट। क्योंकि अगर उसको आपको पूछा गया थोड़ा सा स्लाइटली रिफ्रेम करके क्रिटिकली एसेस ऐसा बोला गया, तो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन का एस्पेक्ट भी हमें डालना पड़ेगा, नो डाउट अबाउट दैट, बट नॉनदलेस वी हैव टू ऑल्सो पॉइंट आउट अंडरस्कोर सर्टन लिमिटेशंस, ओके, वॉट एवर लिमिटेशंस वी वर विटनेस टू, कीपिंग इन माइंड द रिसेंट इलेक्शंस, ओके, वो भी हमें करना पड़ेगा। लेकिन यस, और ये लास्ट दिया है मैंने, हाँ, एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ, क्योंकि ये इतना डिस्कशन में है, ओके, इवैल्यूएट द यूजफुलनेस ऑफ एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ इन मेंटेनिंग द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन कोलिशन इरा, ऑल्सो मेंशन वेज टू स्ट्रेंथन द लॉ इन द लाइट ऑफ द रिसेंट इवेंट। सो एक्ट का इवैल्यूएशन दिया है, देन वे फॉरवर्ड क्या है वो भी मैंने दिया है। अब देखिए, दिस इज जस्ट वन वे ऑफ अप्रोचिंग GS2, स्पेशली कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोसेस, एंड यू कैन लुक एट इट एज सॉर्ट ऑफ अ मॉडल इन द सेंस ऑफ पुटिंग फॉरवर्ड ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट इन एज प्रिसाइज मैनर एज पॉसिबल। वन, टू, यू हैव टू ब्रिंग टू द टेबल एज मेनी रेलिवेंट एग्जाम्पल्स एज पॉसिबल, ओके। सो लेट मी स्टॉप हियर बिकॉज सर इज वेटिंग देयर। सो 5 वाजले ना म्हणजे, यस, इट इज 5। सो इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट आई कैन टेक अप, लेट अस से 1-2 डाउट्स। यू आर गोइंग टू गेट अ डिटेल नोट ऑन करंट इवेंट्स, पॉलिटी, IR, एंड फॉर दैट मैटर ईच एंड एवरी अदर सब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम द GS, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट। एंड ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ द शेड्यूल ऑफ द टेस्ट सीरीज फॉर GS। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 23rd, टेक इट एज सीरियसली एज पॉसिबल, एंड फॉर ऑप्शनल्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 27th ऑफ जून, यस। फॉरगेट अबाउट द प्रिलिम स्कोर, गेट स्टार्टेड विद द मेंस, देखा जाएगा जो भी होगा उसका। सो इज देयर एनी डाउट इन रिगार्ड विद अप्रोचिंग एनी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन मटीरियल? हाँ, यस, हाँ, दिस इज फॉर PSIR। मी तेच तर सांगितलं ना तुम्हाला, यू शुड रेफर इट इन अ व्हेरी सिलेक्टिव मॅनर, ॲटलीस्ट फॉर 5-6 इम्पॉर्टंट टॉपिक्स विच आर ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया। हां, कमीत कमी मित्रमैत्रिणींचे तरी वापरा, हां, स्वतः विकत घ्यायचं नसेल तर फ्रेंडचं बघा, म्हणजे जे काय असेल ते घ्या म्हणजे, बट डू रीड दॅट। See, once again I'll repeat, preamble, fundamental rights, directive principles, federalism, parliamentary system, panchayati raj, just one aspect, local cell government along with panchayati raj and the urban local bodies, okay, then you would not find out the kind of material we have included in this on all what constitutional, statutory and non-statutory institutions. Okay, we have covered all institutions, right from Election Commission of India to Niti Aayog. Sab kuch hai usme. Wo to constitution mein hai hai. GS2 ka hissa hai na wo. GS2 ka hissa hai. So there are 7-8 important topics, okay, which are very, very useful. And you should make it a point to refer to this because these are the kinds of questions which are asked by UPSC every year. ओके, एनीथिंग एल्स? काही नाही, येस येस, देर इज अ डिटेल नोट ऑन दॅट, वी हॅव सी जस्ट 4-5 डेज, डोंट वरी अबाउट दॅट, इन्क्लुडिंग द इलेक्शन, द डिटेल नोट ऑन इलेक्शन अँड द रिलेटेड टॉपिक्स, सो कोएलिशन गव्हर्नमेंट, रोल ऑफ रिजनल पार्टीज, देन इट्स इम्पॅक्ट ऑन फेडरलिझम, सेंट्रल स्टेट रिलेशनशिप, सो एन एन सो फोर, सो हॅव उस, डोंट वरी अबाउट दॅट। Okay, so wish you all the best. Thank you.